and welcome or welcome back to my channel if you're new here. My name is Jennifer, and in today's special tutorial, I'm going to show you how I make name tags. All of these beautiful name tags, well, maybe not all of them. We're going to be making this one, and this one. So everything but the ballerina name tag. And I'm just doing some Etsy orders, and I'm just going to take you along with me on how I make them. So yeah, a lot of orders. Oh my gosh, this is the biggest order I've gotten. 10 name tags. That's a lot, and it takes a while. So I will show you my process, and let's just dive into it. Okay, so we're starting off with some felt and my 5x7s. I have two of them, so I'm gonna have to do four of these 5x7s. 505 spray, some stabilizer. I use cutaway from All Stitch, and I need to get some bigger stabilizers because I ran out, so I'm just waiting for my shipment. I bought a big roll so I can just cut as much as I need, or pre-cut them, so I don't have to use two of my, these are like 5x5s, maybe they're 6x6s, I don't remember. But they're too small. These are for my 4x4 hoops. But since I don't have any more, I'm using these for my name tags. So I am gonna be floating all of these. And by floating, I mean I'm not hooping the felt. I am going to be using the spray to adhere the felt onto the stabilizer. So we're just tightening this, and then I'm gonna spray it. But first, I'm gonna cut out my felt. So I'm just kind of, I like to cut it as I go, because I buy my felt by the yard. So I'm gonna cut two of these, because I need one for the front and then one for the back. If you've ever made felties, it's a very similar process. So I'm just taking this, I'm like, that piece won't work, so I'm just gonna cut two of these out. And these are all rough cuts. And then when I cut these out, I'm gonna use one, and I'm gonna spray it onto the top. Put that over there. And we are ready for our first one. So that goes on the back, just like that. Okay, so I'm gonna spray this bad boy. Give it a little shake and just spray it right on top of the stabilizer. And I don't need that much, so just press it into the corners. Make sure it's nice and flat. And then we're gonna move over to the machine. Okay, so I have my design loaded up on the USB, and I've got my awesome friend's mug with hot chocolate, because why not? And I'm gonna load up the designs here. Just a simple USB that I use. And we're gonna start with the holly leaves, because there's three of them. So I'm just trying to do them in batches, and I'll show you the entire process, but I'm just gonna find, whoops, put that center. I'm gonna put my hoop on here. I always check to make sure that the bobbin has enough thread on it, because I have started one of these and I accidentally was like halfway through a project and forgot to refill the bobbin. So I always check that, and I'm just finding my pattern here. Oh, I love you. Gotta sift through all of these. Nope, not that one. Is it this one? No, it must be that one. That's the one. Okay. So we're just starting with three name tags at a time. And I am just going to speed up the process, because 10. This is the biggest order I've ever received. So this is going to take me several hours to do because I have to do 4 different hoopings. So I'm just going to show you the process. It's just tracing right now just to show me where the patterns are going to end. And luckily I have plenty of room, so that's not a problem. But we're going to start the process, so... So real quick, this design is, I made this design with a Hatch embroidery software. That's what I use. I know a lot of people use Essential Elements. That's a very popular one, but I wanted a software that I could literally do anything with. So that's what I use. I use Hatch embroidery. If you're interested, I will probably link something down below so you know. So you can check that out. So, okay, so I'm just gonna cut some of these threads. And now that it's all cleaned up, we are going to spray the back of this. And we're going to add the backing to these name tags. And luckily, the spray works really well to keep it in place until I can get some stitches in there. And then it doesn't move. So I've had a lot of success doing this. All right. Now that that's on there, I'm going to slide this back on. Readjusting the camera so you can see what I'm doing. Okay. Now, trying to get a good angle is tricky sometimes. So I'm just going to change the thread. Because it was red, and now I just got to put white in here. And I've got these really big cones. You see those big cones back there? So I've got 2 white cones, a black cone, and a blue cone right back here. And this little holder is so handy. If I'm able to get either another one or even a bigger one, that would be great, because having the bigger cones, by the way, all the big cones that I get are from Allstitch. I could leave a link down there if you want to check those out too, but they're a lot cheaper to get than the smaller cones. So I'm just grabbing my thread here and literally just threading it. If it'll stay, there we go. Okay, this is literally what takes forever, is changing out the colors. Oops, let me reposition the needle here. There we go. Okay. Yeah, that happens sometimes. So if you have a hard time threading your needle, just reposition your needle and you should be good to go. Okay, so while this is going, I did prep my second hoop because I do have another one. So I like to make sure that's prepped and ready to go so I can just literally, once this is done, I can just pop it on and start the next batch. So once I'm done with these 3, I have 7 more to go. So, okay, so these are done, and I'm just going to trim the threads here, and then I'm going to add the fray check on the ends, and I'll show you how I do that. That is so when I cut it out, it will not, there's the fray check. I literally put it around the outer edge here. So, before I do that, I'm going to get these threads off. So I'm just trimming up threads as close as I can. Make it all pretty back here. Because it's important. These are going to be hanging on stockings. I want them to be nice and pretty in the back. Okay. I really need to get a lint roller is what I need to get. I have one somewhere, I just don't know where it is. And I ordered new scissors because these scissors are so dull. I've even tried sharpening them with my knife sharpener and it was a fail. Just did not sharpen. And I think that these curved scissors, because they're so old, they don't quite meet. That's probably another reason though. So they're probably a little bit bent. So I just bought new ones. So hopefully those will be here soon. Okay. Those are pretty cleaned up. Now I'm gonna put the fray check on. So this stuff is awesome. I use it for all my name tags and all my patches that I make. And this makes it so that when I cut it out, if for some reason there's a thread that I accidentally cut, it won't like fray. So. And I just like to put it all around the edge, and I like to put it where I clip the threads. Like right there. So. This stuff is awesome. If you've never used it, you'll like it. It does a really great job. Now I'm gonna do the front. So I'm gonna do the front of these. And luckily it hardens clear. And it's not like really, really hard. So when it does dry, I usually give it about 25 to 30 minutes to dry. And which is great because I'm gonna be making more of these. So I'm just gonna let this sit while I make the next one. And I'm just gonna show you the rest of these, fast forward through them all, because like I said, it took a while to make all these. And I still have two more orders to bake, so I won't show you those two orders because then the video will be too long, but I'll show you how I package them. So I'm just gonna set this aside, and now I'm gonna start the next one. This is the last one. to make, and we're gonna let that dry since I just put fray check on it. And I'm gonna grab the ones that are already dry, and we're gonna cut these out using some scissors. These scissors, okay, these scissors are really good. However, they have like a spring in them, and the little clasp on it broke, so there's no way for me to close the scissors. So, not a big fan of these type of scissors. If it didn't have the spring on them, these would be fabulous scissors because they're super sharp, and they cut really well, and they're really reliable. But the spring in them just don't like it. So anyway, I'm just showing you how I cut these out, and I like to give myself a little bit of an edge, just so they're not too close. I just find they look better that way. And I'm just gonna cut all of these out. And I'm just gonna put those scraps to the side there and finish the rest of these. Okay, so we've migrated to my desk, and now we're doing cording. I don't show you how to make cording in this particular video, but I do have a separate video that I have dedicated to cording. If you don't know how to make cording, I will link it up here in the cards, so please watch that. It's a very short video, very informative. This is how I make cording for all of my, even like, I make it for all of my stockings as well as these name tags. So I am just creating a hole with my needle, swirling it around. Sometimes I like to take my little curved scissors and like puncture a hole. Sometimes it's easier to do that. It just depends on my mood. And we're just going to tie these ends together. Just like that. And some of these tags have different colored cordings. So the snowflake name tags have a kind of a light blue and a dark blue cording that goes with them. And most of these name tags have the red and green. So keep it generic. If I can get this knot tied, jeez, this knot does not want to be tied. Oh my gosh. I normally don't have a problem. But for some reason, it just doesn't want to tie for me. Did I get it that time? Yeah. Okay, finally. It doesn't usually take me that long. I'll grab my scissors and trim the end, and we'll be all good. And then I'll do the rest of these off camera, and then I'm going to show you how I package them. Okay, so I did two more orders off camera. There was only five of them, so luckily it didn't take me as long, but this is how I packaged them. So this is the biggest order that I've received, and I've been trying to figure out like the best way to like package it. So I ended up doing like a stack of six and then a stack of four, basically. And then I put my purchase orders in here. If it'll go in there, it's so stuffed. I think that's the max capacity. 10 name tags. All right, so I'm going to close this up. And I do print my own stickers. I print my own, like, shop stickers. I do purchase my thank you stickers. So these ones I printed up on my Rolo. And if you want to see a video of me doing that, let me know. And I do put my... see, look at that. Ooh, it is packed in there. And I'm going to put, I like to, put the, sometimes I like to put the thank yous inside, sometimes outside. It's always different every time. So this time I'm just going to stick it right there. Call it good. And, these are polymailers I got them on Amazon. If you want, I can link all the stuff that I use in the description box so you can see what I use. But yeah, this one was a big order, so I'm trying not to pull too hard on it. Normally they go in pretty easy, but this one's kind of snug. If I can get in there, there we go. It fits. Okay. So I'm going to close it up, and then I'm going to put the label on it. There's my husband. I must have dropped the key somewhere. We like to use keys to lock up our pantry because otherwise children would eat us out of house and home. So we lock up all of our pantry. So, all right, so there's the label for those, and then I'm gonna do the other two. So, and again, I do it differently with each one. Normally I like to do like the thank you sticker on, like, I'll show you here. I'll put a thank you sticker like on the actual name tag itself to close this up. And then I'll stick that in with the purchase order. And I do, because I've got a coupon, so I've got a coupon in there, so they know that they have a coupon in there. And then I'll print out a purchase order on my Rollo and stick it on each of these white envelopes so they know what's inside. So yeah. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more of these types of videos, these kind of like work with me videos, let me know in the comment section. I've got lots of new items that I want to make for my shop that I would like to record. So if you want to see those, let me know. So I didn't do this for the other order because it was so stuffed. So, but that's usually what I do. I usually put a purchase order on the actual white envelope so I know what's inside. And then I put it in the poly mailer. So. It's amazing the difference. Believe it or not, I don't run Etsy ads on my shop. I never have. So I am literally using organic growth. I'm trying to grow my Etsy shop organically so that I don't have to rely on ads to get sales. Yes, it takes longer to grow, and I understand that, but I want my customer base to be genuine. Like I don't want to like spend $10 to $20 on ads to see if I can get more, you know, views, and then if I can't afford those anymore, and then just lose a bunch of sales. So I don't want to have to rely on ads to get sales. So I am growing as organically as possible. And I don't know if, because I've been star seller for 2 months in a row, and I've gotten more sales. Like November was my most profitable month, and I have no idea if it was because of the star seller or not. Not sure. I mean, my Etsy shop isn't exactly an old one. It's definitely on the newer side. Technically, it's been open since 2015, but I didn't start actually like working at it until maybe beginning of last year. So anyway, it's hard to tell whether the organic growth is from the star seller or if it's just, I don't know, my items, tags, who knows. So, but I'm very grateful for all of my orders. If you've ordered through my shop, let me know what you think, and I appreciate all of my customers and all of my followers. You guys are awesome. And if you're brand new here, hit the subscribe button. I do embroidery, Etsy shop. I make Busilla kits. I do all that kind of thing. I even throw in some vlogs here and there. I like to keep it real. All right. Well, I'm exhausted. That was a lot of work. Oh my goodness. Okay, so it took me about, I'd have to say, 3 hours to make that 110 name tag order. And about a whole day to finish the rest of it. So, all right, so this is the end of the video. And I hope to see you guys in my next one. Bye.